Hello, my name is Regina Schenk, and I lead a ministry called Global Transformation International. And our heart is to see the nations of the world align with God's destiny for them. And we know that God has called every nation and tribe and tongue to worship Him because He alone is worthy. And I want to talk to you today about the need for encouragement in the world. You are probably a Christian if you're watching this. If you're not, I hope that Jesus reaches out to you during this season. But if you are, people need encouragement. And I know that God has called us to break every yoke. And I want to share the scripture with you out of Luke 4. And this is Jesus talking. And He says, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because He's anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of sight for the blind, to release the oppressed, and to proclaim the year of God's favor." When I walk around, whether I'm going grocery shopping or buying gifts for my family, I run into people who have trouble smiling. And I'll smile at them, and sometimes they'll smile back, but most of the time, they're so busy trying to get their list done. And it's not Santa Claus who's checking his list. We are. We're checking our lists, and we're trying to get everything done and prepare for the season. But I believe God wants us to recognize that His Son was sent to free us from that kind of oppression and that false responsibility. A couple of days ago in this room where I'm recording this, we had 10 people, and every one of them were sharing their hearts with each other, and we were sharing about yokes that we were carrying. One yoke was false responsibility. One yoke was fear about their children. Another yoke was fear of lack during this season. And so Jesus came not only to heal someone who's lame physically, but He came to break the heavy yokes that we carry in life. And I'll never forget the time I was trying to get everything done. And I was reading in Isaiah, I think it was chapter 30, and it said, "In repentance and rest you would be saved, but you would not. You said, 'No, we will flee on horses.'" And I've been guilty of that. I've had so much to do that I just ran to get the things done. But I thought, I have to take time to rest in this season. And that rest is resting on His ability, resting on His love, resting on His provision. God is able. He's able to do everything we need Him to do. He may not do it the way we want Him to, but He will do it. And He is the greatest gift this Christmas season. So I just want to encourage you today that if you see someone who's not smiling, pray for them. Maybe just give them a nice touch and say, "The Lord bless you," or "Merry Christmas." Whatever it takes to encourage someone in the earth today. We broke those yokes in this room. We broke those yokes because God is able to take our burdens. And the person who was worried about a child turned that child over to the Lord in prayer. The person who was concerned about false responsibility repented for carrying responsibility they weren't supposed to carry and turning that over to the Lord. And so we are here to let the oppressed go free. So if you're oppressed today and you're having trouble getting everything done, can I just suggest that maybe you sit down before the Lord and you begin to worship Him and turn your heart over to Him and say, "Lord, I give You my list. I give You these troubles. I give You my family." And let the Lord carry that for you. One time I was talking to the Lord about how heavy I felt about things, and He said, "I'm a gentleman. I will carry your packages." And so the Lord wants to carry your packages and carry you, not only through this season, but every season of your life. And one more word before I quit. I really believe some people think because they get older, they're supposed to retire and the young people are supposed to do it. I don't think that's the way it is. I believe it was Joshua and Caleb who waited for their victory and they got their promise, and they were older when they got it. God is never going to take away His promises from you. They could be delayed, but they will not be denied. And I'm here to tell you, God has dreams for you, He has vision for you, and there's so much to do for the kingdom. So rise up, get your rest from the Lord, and then go set some captives free during this season. The Lord bless you, come to our website, Global Transformation International, and help us help other people, not only in this nation, but in the nations of the world. And from us at Global Transformation International, Merry Christmas, and may you get a new beginning and start fresh with His grace in this coming year.